Negros Oriental 3rd District Representative Arnulfo Teves is one of the 2 to 3 masterminds being considered in the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo, according to Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla. Remulla revealed that Teves is being considered as a mastermind after he was asked on the whereabouts of the people behind the Degamo case.
They can be contacted, I think. They're always in social media. Meron naman nasa social media dyan. Meron nga yung isa para nag-text sa akin. I told you about it last week. Congressman Teves texted me.
This was revealed as the DOJ recommends the filing of sets of information against the 6 of the 10 respondents for 9 counts of murder for the killing of Degamo and 8 others. They will also be charged with 13 counts of frustrated murder and 3 counts of attempted murder. The lawyer of Teves, Attorney Ferdinand Topacio, said he is no longer surprised that his client may be tagged as a mastermind.
This is anticlimactic. Umpisa pa naman noong nag-umpisa ang investigasyon, lahat ng oblique references, lahat ng innuendo, Teves. So we are not surprised. Para sa amin, huwag nang magawa ng pasaring na may illegal gambling.
Topacio challenged Remulla to file the case in court. Remulla said the case may be filed before the end of the month.
Kasi sa ganito, we cannot defend ourselves. Huwag na sanang magsalita kung hindi pa sigurado. Kasi may mga statements na I think, I'm not sure, it's possible. Complete the case build up and please file it para marinig na po sa ng prosecutor.
Sa court na, pa-file na sa court. Yes, yes. Kasi yung mga nag-surrender nung last week na inquest na sila, no? They surrendered a few days ago, 'di ba? 5 days ago, Thursday, Friday, surrender sila. They were in our custody by Friday, no?
Remulla also said the brother of Congressman Teves, former Governor Pride Henry Teves, may also be implicated in the Degamo case. This comes after the raid by the Philippine National Police Criminal Investigation and Detection Group at the sugar mill and other properties of the former governor in Santa Catarina, Negros Oriental, where high-powered firearms, ammunition, explosives, and 18 million pesos in cash were confiscated. Remulla said one of the suspects in the Degamo case was in the area and actually saw the preparation of the explosives.
It's used for assassination, it's used for to create havoc, it's used to kill people. So, nakita niya ginagawa yan. And yung gumagawa nun that he said, was part of the people we arrested also. Nakasama sa mga sumurrender then later on.
In the report of the Joint Negros Task Force CIDG, included in the latest raid is a short firearm with live ammunition, 3 magazines, and 2,000 live bullets. Interior Chief Benhur Abalos issued a warning to an unnamed person who he says was most likely the mastermind of the Degamo assassination based on the evidence they have uncovered.
Alam kong alam mo kung sino ka. Sumuko ka na. Sumuko ka na. Lahat ng ebidensyang ito, nakita naman natin sa ilang nakaraang araw. Yung mga mismong pumatay, nasa kustodiya na. Alam mo kung sino ka. Sumuko ka na. At sa iba pang hindi pa ho sumusuko, iba ang utak ng taong ito. He's very, very devious. He's very evil.
Former Governor Teves said in a text message that he has already reached out to the Justice Secretary and he is ready to answer questions if needed. He will also be transparent as to his phone logs and even bank transactions.
We have to respect the rights of people. He has to undergo preliminary investigation for this. So we will look. I have no copy of the warrant. I have no copy of the proceedings leading to the warrant. But we'll see.
While the raid was done in Negros Oriental, Remulla said the complaint about the confiscated items may eventually be filed before the prosecutor's office in Metro Manila. Adrian Ayalin, ABS-CBN News.